Hey guys, Ralph here. True Power, Trumpet Fitness. Can't wait to get going today. It's a beautiful day out here in Connecticut. It's still 10 o'clock in the morning. Usually I'm getting these out in the afternoon because I've been so busy. But I ran this morning. I've done some kettlebell. I have not played. I am going to do some bike at about 11 o'clock when I get through practicing. But I want to talk about horn angle. Okay? This has come up on several emails. And certainly, there's a couple things on the forums as well. My views on this are simple. I've talked about it before, but I just want to get it done, and that's that. Now, I'm going to play a little ditty that I played at a funeral yesterday at church. I'd never heard it before. It's called An Irish Prayer. Now, my mother is very, very Irish, so I'd heard the prayer, the poem before, the Irish Prayer. May the road rise to greet you, may the wind be at your back, all that sort of thing. It's a beautiful poem, but I'd never heard it put to music before, and it really came off well. If you can picture a really good organ player with a cello, it went well. Okay, let me get this going in horn angle, and we'll get to it. Very, very pretty. An Irish Prayer. Check it out at some point. I love lyrical playing. Anyway, horn angle. Guys, it is so simple. I've had a couple questions. Actually from the lower brass group, actually. And again, lower brass is not my forte, but I don't see any reason in the world that it doesn't, what my philosophy doesn't work with lower brass as well. Horn angle is predicated on one thing, and one thing only, okay? And that is the structure of your face, the structure of your teeth, the structure of your jaw, the your muscles. That is what is going to predicate your horn angle. As long as your tongue is gripping the bottom lip, everything else is where it's supposed to be. Case closed. It's as simple as that. Now, here's the deal. One of the emails was talking, a trombone player that studied with Jay Friedman, and was saying that Friedman is talking about adjusting the horn angle many different ways according to your stream of air. Okay. Well, here we go again, the stream of air. There is very little air getting into my horn. There's nothing to adjust to. Every single note that you play, every vibration that you play is done inside the mouth and with the lip before you even put the horn up to your lips. That's what I was doing. That's what I was doing. Okay? Now, again, I don't believe that there is, especially in the upper register, an extreme upper register, there is hardly any air getting into the horn, so there's nothing to adjust to. It is all done before you even put the mouthpiece on the lips. So to adjust to an airstream, especially different angles while you are playing, makes absolutely no sense to me. Okay? Now, if it works for Jay Friedman, so be it. I don't know how much air is getting into his horn. Now, most wind players have a downward stream. Flute, no question, it's a downward stream. We did the flute the other day. Whatever is getting through, I can feel a little bit down there. I feel nothing here. So it's a downward stream. So for me to put the instrument at a downward angle, it'd look like I'm playing a clarinet. That's not the way my jaws are set. That's not the way my lips are formed. That's not the way my teeth are formed. It makes no sense. It makes no sense. Now, on top of that, there are absolutely great players that have the funkiest horn angles you've ever seen. Horst Pfister is like this. I did a video about the top chops players in the world today. I talked about a guy named Jim Hines. Absolutely. Point it up. The great Adolf Scherbaum, the precursor to Maurice André. Now, he didn't have the virtuosity and the musicianship of Maurice. He was stronger than him. Plays like a clarinet. Okay? Most everybody is pretty much straight. And it is not, the horn angle should be as simple as can be. I can't begin to tell you how many students I've had come in here and say, well, my old teacher said my horn angle. I said, I don't hear about it. Forget it. It has nothing to do with anything. If you are thinking about your horn angle while you are playing, you are thinking about the wrong thing. It's as simple as that. You are thinking about the wrong thing. First of all, by the time you get to a concert or performance, you should be thinking about the music only. Okay? In practice, you're thinking about one thing and one thing only. That's the tongue position. All the while I was playing just there, even in the lower register, in lyrical, I'm thinking about keeping the tongue forward and firm against the bottom lip. Now, as I get lower, the tongue gets softer. In the upper register, it gets firm, 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 and it's very easy to lock it in. In the lower register, sometimes since it gets, the lips get more relaxed and the tongue gets more relaxed, the tongue will go back and it will get away from me a little bit. So I'm constantly thinking lyrical playing to keep that tongue forward. And that's one thing, horn angle, oh my God. If you're in a performance and you're thinking about your horn angle, man, you're screwed. Okay? Now, if you're thinking about the horn angle in your practice, and you know, that's one thing. To me, horn angle, schmangle. The tongue will tell you everything you need to know. Strongest muscle in the body, certainly the strongest muscle of the embouchure. Just think of the tongue. Okay, guys, I hope that answers your question, and have a great day. Love you all. One.